nice, man. It's nice. Hey, then what am I doing?
It looks nice, it looks all that, but how often do we actually come to this cross and realize, man, this is what my Savior died on? This is the symbol of salvation. This was the turning point in history. This is why I can come sing in church. This is why we got mics and amplifiers. This is why we have functions and places where people can come. This is why we go out and we talk to the people on the street and we go into the neighborhood. This is why we go on mission trips. This is why we do the things we do. How often do we make just not we're not praising a wooden idol. We're praising the what it represents.
Yes.
The symbol of the turning point in life as we know it. How often do we do that? How often do we find ourselves at the foot of the cross? In closing, I say this. When we did that play Easter Sunday, that was a revelation to me. Even in that little bit. And I just wanted to do him justice by even playing that role, but in doing that, I just thought about it. As I was up here on this cross, now see, Christ was naked. He was naked. He was humiliated. Now, he was naked as he hung on this cross for 6 hours. Was it 6 or 9 hours? It was 6 hours. As he hung for 6 hours on this cross, he was just naked. And even with my clothes on, even with my costume on, I could feel these splinters in my back. And like, if you go up too fast, you go down too fast, it's gonna get you.
Mm-hmm.
Not only that, just standing up against the cross, just trying to imagine or trying to put myself, I could even feel the splinter just then. Thank you, Lord. I may have been attacked, I don't know. But just in that point of just trying to hold myself in a position to make it look like I was hanging on the cross, to realize that he actually hung.
Mm-hmm.
Now they justify by saying they tied ropes around his arm to the cross. But if you think about it, why would they do that if this was a means of torture? Why would they tie his arms to the cross? He hung by the nails.
That's right. That's right.
And they drove a nail through his feet. So all this pressure, not only that, I don't think there's a real depiction of how they nailed his feet to the cross, but if they did nail them like this, that's his body weight was on his feet as they hung sideways like this. And one spike going through 2 feet. And that's where all the pressure of his body as he hung on that cross. And his back was open. So as he leaned up, it wasn't like my back wasn't open. My back was not ripped. My flesh was not ripped. And I felt splinters even then. His back was open. Now, if they nailed him to the cross while it was laying on the ground, then that means before he hung, before his muscles were stretched to the limit, he laid on it. And he laid on that with an open wound throughout his whole back. He laid on a cross with splinters. And there's no telling how that cross looked. There's no telling. You know, this right here is a fine wood. So why would Roman soldiers put him on a fine wood? This right here is kind of sanded, kind of nice looking. You can pick it up. Won't hurt your hand. And then they take and they raise him up. So I think about the Passion of the Christ. They had this hole in the ground that when they raised him up, the cross slid in, boom, and you're hanging on this cross as it is already. And then when it goes in, you feel all that. A joke. And this crown of thorns, truly, this is not even a, this is just a imitation. And these thorns, they hurt to take, and they took and they smote it on his head. They took and they hit it. And they shoved it down on his head.
That's right.
On top of all that, from the moment they picked him up in the garden to the moment that he hung on the cross, you know, it's a movie called The Purge. And I truly am closing. I just want, you know, this is something we don't, I'm making a point. Now, it's a movie called The Purge, and what it is, it was a futuristic type of America where one night a year, people could do anything they wanted to do. Mm-hmm. Anything. It was just one of those things to kind of a release, kind of a release of pressure. Now, all the 364 days of the year, you could obey the law, do what's right. But on this one night, you could do whatever you want. If you want to rape kids, you could do it. If you want to rob stores, you could do it. If you want to kill people, you could do it. Whatever you wanted to do. And to realize for 364 days, you're just waiting on this one day, so you're pinning up anger. You may have a neighbor that you can't stand everything you do on the purge, you're going to get them. So you have that type of buildup and pressure on you. Anybody ever work with pressure vessels or something like that? When you build up that type of pressure, when it's going to blow, it's going to blow. So think about that as Christ, from the moment that they picked him up in the garden to the moment that he was on that cross alone by himself while he's walking. There was no holding back just as he walked with all they had, enjoying this beating. So it was like they enjoyed it. So it wasn't like I'm not necessarily mad at you. It's just because I can. Mm-hmm. To be spit on. And then I don't believe it was just punching at me. Kicked and hit. Not only that, you got open wounds on your body right now. And they just, you talking about you got a bruise right here and then somebody take and hit that bruise again? Your back is open and somebody taking and throwing a rock at your back? And it's open? Wounded? Ripped? You feeling all that. And on top of that, just the feeling nobody's on your side. All your disciples have abandoned you, or whoever was there, they as far as here to the doorway from you. Because they don't want nobody to recognize. I'm one of his disciples. I was the one who was with him everywhere he went. So while you carrying this cross down this way, nobody right now is on your side. You might hear him crying out, oh, don't do this, Jesus, don't do it. But it's drowned out by the ones crucified. Name calling. This name, this horrible name, just being called all out your name and just degraded as a human, to be treated as less than a human. To be looked at as trash. Doing all this, you making your way, you dehydrated. You ain't had no water, ain't had no food, and body just weak, and now you gotta carry this cross, and every time you stumble, they hitting you and cussing you and beating on you and telling you, get up and come on and what, man, King of the Jews, and just disrespecting who you are. Just, God, you okay, son of God, what you gonna do now? That's what I thought. You ain't nobody. I ought to go up on this cross and hang on it naked. And for 2,000 years later, just to become a mascot. And not be preached, because you say God all day, but Jesus Christ is the turning point in what we believe. Jesus Christ makes our faith real. But in church is to become a mascot. And not even be mentioned in some sermons. To have prominent musicians. To be looked at as a joke. And even in some church services, it's not even real worship. It's a tradition. This is just the way we do it. To have your word taken and they take one thing and make a religion out of that. They take another thing, make a religion over here, and these two can't even get along. luxury is not mine.